Nimble Streamer now allows receiving WebRTC streams ingested via WHEP signaling. Let's see the minimum steps required to set up WebRTC reception. We have Nimble Streamer latest version installed with live transcoder package, which is also required. First, we will enable the feature by adding a couple of parameters in Nimble config file on the server as shown here. Another important requirement is SSL. We have already set it up for our demo. Please refer to our documentation for SSL setup details. Once the configuration is complete, we restart Nimble instance. Now we need to set up proper authorization for ingested streams. We do it using applications that we add via our control panel. Define application name, which we'll use later, and also user and password credentials. Before moving forward, let's test if Nimble is set up properly to receive the ingest. We do it using our JavaScript publishing library and our publishing demo page. In the publishing URL, you use application name, user and password, which we've just described. The stream name can be anything. We also specify that we'll use VP8 ingest codec by adding proper parameter. The browser will require proper camera and mic access. Once the publishing is started, we can see the image and log entries confirming the connection. Now let's see if the stream is processed properly in Nimble by going to live streams list. You can see a stream with Opus audio and VP8 video as we defined in our URL. To generate the output in more suitable codecs like H.264 and AEC, we'll use Nimble Live Transcoder. We add a simple scenario with video and audio decoder elements, then add encoder elements for H.264 video and AEC audio. Once we save the scenario, it will sync up within a few seconds. The transcoded result streams will appear in live output streams. You can see proper video and audio codecs being used. Let's watch the stream via SLDP, for example. The source image is changing, so does the resulting stream. Simple authorization allows checking that everything is set properly. However, the credentials may be compromised, so for production environment, we recommend using Publish Control Framework. It allows using flexible capabilities to authorize users with your own business logic. Please check video description for more information related to WebRTC setup.